The two-day webinar will give you a presentation of the basic principle of blood quality control. Quality control is not so easy, and some notions, when not used on a daily basis, could be easily confused. So I will try to give clear and clean foundations from which people would be able to improve their own knowledge. This is especially important in regards to the increasing regulatory constraints and, of course, to provide the best results as possible. I will first talk about the target values, which are the key of the quality control, and then I will explain the differences of very often confused notions, which are precision, accuracy, and trueness. After to have clarified those notions, I will explain the specificities of the different quality controls: internal quality control, externalized internal quality control, and external quality control. To start, and regarding the process, blood analysis and clinical sign observations are leading to make a diagnosis and then to provide the more appropriate treatment to the patient. Quality control is the assessment of the analytical process of blood analysis. The laboratory will receive controlled blood samples for which the values of each parameter are known, and those values are called target values. Then, the laboratory will run the control samples and compare its results to the target values. If the results are close enough to the target values, the results could be validated. If it's not the case, the laboratory will have to set some corrective actions to be closer to the target values. So, let's go a bit deeper on the target value. These target values can have different origins. First, they can be delivered from the provider of the control samples. But it is really recommended for the laboratory to set its own target values and confidence ranges. The last possibility is that the target value comes from the peer group. The peer group corresponds to all laboratories using the same instrument and same technology. So all similar laboratories which are part of the same quality control program. In hematology, there is no real international standard to define the true value of a parameter. So we are considering the peer group mean as assimilated to the true value, because it may include a bigger number of values to calculate the mean than the other target values. And the target value is simply a mean of several control sample runs. As we cannot expect the laboratory to exactly reach the target values, the results have to be inside a certain closeness to the target value. This closeness around the mean corresponds to the confidence range. This confidence range should statistically include 99% of the results and corresponds to 3 standard deviation or plus or minus 3 SD. Plus or minus 2 SD is including 95% of the results, and plus or minus 1 SD is including only 68% of the results. And to calculate its own standard deviation, or SD, the laboratory will start by running several times the control sample. Then it will measure the differences between all individual results and the mean. All those individual differences will be then summed together. This sum will then be divided by the number of results minus 1. After making the square root of the previous obtained value, you will have the value of 1 SD. And this gap to the mean is including 34% of the result. Now, taking plus or minus 1 SD around the mean will include the double, so 68% of the result. By default, we are considering that the confidence range is equal to plus or minus 3 SD including 99% of the results. Now we know the specificities of the target values, I would like to clarify some basic notions. Indeed, the precision, accuracy, and trueness are sometimes confused. First, the precision. The precision compares the closeness of the results between each other. His aim is to assess the stability of the system to see if different runs of the same control sample give the same results. The accuracy is the comparison between one unique value to the true value. But as you have only one unique value, the lack of precision could directly impact the results. It is then highly recommended to check the precision before to assess the accuracy. Trueness is the comparison between a mean of results and the true value. But if we have several imprecise results, the mean could still be acceptable. So the mean is not really impacted by the precision of the results. I will now describe the different quality controls to understand their specificities, starting by the internal quality control. What is it? The IQC is a daily control which allows to check the stability of the process between two accuracy or trueness assessments. Stability of the process will be expressed by the precision through the coefficient of variation, or CV. How to proceed? The laboratory should run at least two samples, low and high, at morning and evening time to frame the routine analysis. It is recommended to run the control before the shutdown, as this action can impact the analytical process. Generally, all maintenance actions could impact the instrument performances and have to be done out of the result series. If a maintenance action has to be done during the series, a QC has to be run before and after the action to close and reopen the result series. What are we measuring? The precision calculation is based on the SD. One SD is the distance from the mean, and this gap is including 34% of the results. If the value of 1SD is smaller, the 34% of the result containing this gap will be mechanically closer to each other and the precision will be better. The SD expressed in proportion of the mean gives the coefficient of variation, which will reflect the precision. Smaller will be the CV, better will be the precision. What is the target value? For the IQC, the target values can come from either the control sample provider or the laboratory itself. The second option is recommended because the provider's target values can have higher confidence ranges due to the fact that they have to take into account the inter-instrument variations. How to define our own target values? The laboratory will have to simultaneously run the new control sample batch and the current one over at least 5 days. The mean of those results will become the new target value. His confidence range will be calculated by the ASD of those runs. According to his quality policy, the laboratory could choose 2 or 3 SD as confidence range. Now, what are the pros and cons of the IQC? The IQC is first mandatory to validate the daily results, but it is not offering a peer group comparison, which is the only target value assimilated to the true value. Then we have the externalized IQC. What is it? This quality control will allow to monthly assess the trueness and precision by comparing the results to peer group. How to proceed? The externalized IQC will not require additional control sample, as the laboratory can use its daily internal controls. It will just have to send the results to the externalized IQC provider to obtain its peer group comparison. What are we measuring? The trueness and the precision. The trueness is calculated by the Standard Deviation Index, or SDI, comparing the monthly mean of the laboratory with the peer group mean. The Precision Index, or PI, will compare the two CV of the laboratory and the peer group. HORIBA Medical is providing its own externalized IQC, the QCP. It is available for all three disciplines, hematology, hemostasis, and clinical chemistry, and allows to have access to real-time reports. So, what are the pros and cons? The main advantage of the externalized IQC, or QCP, is to compare the results to peer group with an affordable cost. Its drawback is that this quality control is most of the time monthly, except for the QCP, which allows to have access to early real-time reports. As the externalized IQC is comparing only one instrument provider, it has a little bit less diversity in its peer group. The last quality control is the external quality control. What is it? It is generally made by quarter and allows to specifically assess the accuracy. The EQC is also a requirement for the ISO 15189 standard. How to proceed the EQC? The laboratory will receive a control sample from an entity independent from the instrument provider without delivering any target value. So the laboratory will run a blind test and only know the target value after to have sent these results. It will send only one unique value to be compared to the peer group. What are we measuring? The accuracy is calculated as the trueness, except that it is a unique value and not the mean, which is compared to the peer group. What are the pros and cons of the EQC? This external quality control is the regulatory requirement and allow to assess the accuracy. But the accuracy could also be impacted by a bad precision. Instead, the externalized IQC, or QCP, the external quality control is done quarterly, which is a long period without any assimilated true value comparison. And if a manufacturer is overrepresented within the peer group, it could have a bigger impact on the true value definition. Here are summarized the main differences between the quality controls. The IQC is provided with target values, but is recommended for the laboratory to set its own target values. It is allowing to assess the stability of the process between two peer group comparisons and allows to validate the daily results. The externalized IQC allows to assess the trueness and the precision by comparison to a peer group. The external quality control allows to assess the accuracy by a comparison to a peer group. As a reminder, the QCP provided by HORIBA Medical is not an IQC, not an EQC, but an externalized IQC, allowing to compare the daily results with the peer group. And the benefits of this QCP are the ability to use the internal controls, making it more affordable, and offering a peer group comparison continuously accessible by real-time reports. So the QCP is the perfect complementarity between IQC and EQC. Thank you all for your attention.